All right, I'm taking a trip to the foundry in Bozeman. This is getting north in the Madison Valley on a very cold December in 2010. Bronze is an alloy consisting of copper and other metals. The addition of other metals, copper and tin, produces an alloy much harder than plain copper. The historical period where the archaeological records contains many bronze artifacts is known as the Bronze Age. Earliest tin alloy bronze dates to about 6,500 years ago in Serbia, and about 6,000 years ago in Iran and some of the ancient cities of China and Africa. All right, well, here I am just touching or putting little markers with a magic marker, little areas that need to be fine-tuned, you know, little bubbles, little lumps, scrapes in the bronze itself, different things that need to be repaired before I can go to the coloring of the bronze. Bronze, but that's, as you can see here, is a white metal that when it's polished, it actually looks real brassy looking. Here, the metal worker is cleaning up those areas that I've marked, fine-tuning them, getting them ready so that I can go to the final sandblast on this bronze. It's a cold acid called, sulfur, liver sulfur, and that turns it all black. Then he rubs back the areas of the lighter. Isaac is rubbing away the potash in areas where the bronze will be showing through the patina. He does this anywhere where the color of bronze is going to have to show through, like skin and things like that. He just continues with a eraser stick to get in the tighter areas.
And because of the copper in it, it will eventually turn green.
All right, now begins the process of coloring the bronze. The first thing is to get all that wet water from the sulfur, potash solution, dried off. And so he's using a combination of a torch and a air gun. All right, now he's starting to put on the first coat of patina. And what it is a silver nitrate, which turns the bronze white. It's like adding a canvas, or getting a canvas ready for color. That's all he's doing, is just heating the bronze, and the bronze reacts to the heat and to the chemical. And that's where the chemical change comes and the color starts. Now he starts heating up the metal again, and now he's putting on ferric acid over the silver nitrate, which now turns it brown. And he does that wherever we're going to have a leather quality to the metal. And the more he adds, I don't know what he adds to it to make it turn red, but that's what he's doing now, is adding the acid with a brush and heat to the metal, and it turns the blanket to an ochre red, which I wanted. Now he's turning the shirt green. I wanted a green shirt with a blue and red flap at the neck, and he's working on that now. And this He's wearing a buffalo robe, this warrior. I had a Lakota friend of mine tell me that it reminded him of what Crazy Horse would look like. He'd have been very mutely dressed. He wouldn't have been dressed in a lot of regalia. Because he was a hair shirt owner. Now we're doing the beadwork. I'm keeping things rather simple. It's still as things might have been, depending on the beads available to the warrior. And Isaac has used a smaller brush to get into there. And now what I'm doing is putting a design on the pipe bag the way I want it. And he's just finishing it off at the bottom. Oh, the beadwork. Now he's just putting on the finishing touches. Getting the face to the right color that I want. And now here I am just advising him on what I think things should look like, including painting on the dark area of the feathers the way I want them. I'm trying to keep true to the look of a real eagle feather. Now we're getting ready to base the bronze. And holes have been drilled into the bottom of the base to accept screws, as you can see here. He's putting the base on the bronze with screws, and now he's nailing on the name tag. And basically the bronze is done. Here's the final photos that I took of that bronze, and I think it turned out pretty good. I'm happy with it. All right, everybody, have a great night, and I hope you like this revisit of the coloring of Peace Talker.